And then when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, the narrations mention the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's body was still not buried, and Bilal gave the adhan. And when he reached Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, and he looked and there was no messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the narration mentioned that Bilal began to choke and he began to cry, and all those around him began to cry. And for the next 3 days Bilal radiallahu anhu tried to give the adhan. Every time he would reach Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, he would begin to choke. And then he went to Abu Bakr and he said, Abu Bakr, allow me to leave. And Abu Bakr said, no, oh Bilal, you stay with me. I need you. Bilal radiallahu anhu said, Abu Bakr, if you freed me for yourself, then keep me. But if you freed me for the sake of Allah, then let me go. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu allowed him to go. And then one night, Bilal radiallahu anhu was sleeping and he saw a dream. And in the dream, he saw the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, oh Bilal, what is it that you never come to visit us? And he woke up and he traveled towards Medina at a hurried pace.
And then he went to the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he looked at the house of Aisha and he cried. And Hassan and Hussein, they came, and he started crying more because Rasulullah loved them radiallahu anhu majma'in. And then they said, ya Bilal, one last adhan for you to remind us of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi. Just one last adhan. And then one of the people said, they are the grandchildren of Rasulullah, call the adhan for their sake. And he went to call the adhan.
ويصعد على المكان الذي يقف كان عليه أيام رسول الله يؤذن ويؤذن. لما قال الله أكبر الله أكبر ضجت المدينة. الله أكبر الله أكبر صاح الناس في البيوت. أبعث رسول الله، تذكر الصوت الذي كان يؤذن في أيامه صلى الله عليه وسلم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. خرج الرجال من بيوتهم وخرجوا من أسواقهم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أبعث رسول الله، أبعث رسول الله. فلما وصل بلال إلى قوله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله خنقته العبرة، وما استطاع أن يكمل أذانه، ونزل من على المكان الذي كان يؤذن منه. قال الراوي: فما عرفت المدينة يوما أشد بكاء وعويلا بعد يوم وفاته كيوم قال فيه بلال أشهد أن محمد رسول الله.